2021, the matter between the current judge Stabok is the same.
The court pleases. Good morning, my lord. I still appear for the applicant in this matter.
As it pleases the court, I start with the respondent.
Welcome, Mr. Lutibezi. I thought you will not be here.
Yes, there were lockdowns and all these happening, so.
This is a bail application of accused number one in the consolidated criminal cases number 6 and 7 of 2021, Ricardo George Gustavo versus the state as a respondent. Due to my promise that I will deliver the judgment today, the judgment which is not completed at this stage, it still needs editing, some more typing, but nevertheless I've decided to release the order today, and the complete judgment will be released on the 21st of December 2021 at 1500 hours in the afternoon. I just ventured to say that the release of the complete judgment will not necessarily be in open court. It will be by way of rendering copies of the judgment to the legal practitioners concerned and to the interested people of the press, and they can make arrangements with Ms. Iteta, who is my assistant. After careful consideration of the law and the evidence and the documents supplied to me as exhibits during the period 15 to 19 November and also on 25 November 2021, I've reached the following conclusion and the following orders are therefore issued. The accused applicant, Mr. Ricardo Gustavo, shall be released on bail of 800,000 Namibian dollars in respect of the charges leveled against him in the indictment served on and received by Brokerhoff and Associates legal practitioners acting for the accused on 26 October 2021 by depositing the bail amount with the registrar or deputy registrar of the High Court of Namibia, Main Division, alternatively the officer in charge of the Windhoek Correctional Facility or his deputy, and it is subject to the following conditions. One, in the eventuality of the accused being unable to raise the whole amount, the accused shall be allowed to furnish an acceptable guarantee with a surety or sureties in the amount of 500,000 Namibian dollars, which the guarantor and or surety or sureties will pay and forfeit to the state in the event of the accused absconding or attempting to abscond. The guarantee with a surety or sureties shall be rendered to the satisfaction of the registrar or deputy registrar of the High Court of Namibia. If necessary, I just want to explain here that the bail amount remains $800,000 Namibian. And in the eventuality of the accused being unable to raise the whole amount, then it is clear that he will have to pay $300,000 Namibian with the registrar and or the head of the correctional facility, and the balance shall be furnished by way of an acceptable guarantee with acceptable sureties. I read further, condition number two, the accused applicant shall report twice daily at the Cups Farm police station between the hours 700 and 800 and 1200 and 1300 and sign any attendance register provided by and with the officer on duty before leaving the Cups Farm police station. Three, the accused applicant shall report every Monday, Wednesday and Friday between the hours 800 and 1100 with one of the investigating officers at the head office of the Anti-Corruption Commission. Four, the accused applicant shall not leave the demarcated and fenced in area of the Finkenstein estate between the hours 1400 and 700 the next morning unless accompanied by one or more of the investigating officers of the Anti-Corruption Commission. The accused shall sign in and out for purposes of this condition on the available books records at the main entrance exit every time he enters or leaves the set area. Five, the accused applicant shall be restricted to remain within the boundaries of Earth 229 Wildebeest Street, Finkenstein Estate between the hours 1800 to 600 the next morning. Six, the accused applicant shall not be allowed to visit any of the residences or any of his co-accused situated within the Finkenstein estate or elsewhere in the municipal area of the city of Windhoek. Seven, the accused applicant shall not be allowed to visit any of the residences, offices, addresses, or principal places of business of any state witness or any of his co-accused. Eight, the accused applicant shall not be allowed within a radius of 25 kilometers of the Usia Kutaku International Airport. Nine, the accused applicant shall not be allowed within a radius of 1 kilometer of the Eros Airport Windhoek. 10. The accused is not allowed possession, control, or access to any travel documentation of Namibia, Angola, South Africa, Botswana, or any foreign state. 11. The accused applicant is not allowed to visit, communicate, interfere, or contact any witness for the state. And then separately, and any of his co-accused, bracket, after being released on bail, close the bracket. 12. The accused applicant is prohibited from communicating or contacting with any prospective witness or former intended accused of the state originating from Iceland, Angola, South Africa, and the United Arab Emirates, brackets, and or any person or official of or acting on behalf of Tundavala Invest Limited and or Pronto Invest Limited, Dubai. 13. The accused applicant shall not be allowed to venture outside a radius of 22 kilometers, brackets calculated, closer brackets, from the head offices of the city of Windhoek, situated at the corner of Sam Nujoma Drive and Independence Avenue. 14. Before I read 14, I just want to remind that during the bail application, the accused spontaneously and unsolicited offered to wear a GPS or personal GPS device around his wrist or ankle, which he would pay for in order to give peace of mind to the prosecution that they will be able to monitor his whereabouts at all hours of the day. Taking that into account, condition 14 read as follows. The state shall be allowed to, at its own cost, affix a personal GPS device to the wrist or ankle of the accused in order to acquire the ability to monitor the movements of the accused 24/7, brackets, at all hours, closer brackets. Alternatively, the state shall be allowed to affix an advanced GPS device to the vehicles, which the accused is going to use while on bail, and the accused is obliged to identify such vehicle or vehicles. The fixing of the GPS device shall not suspend the accused being released on bail, but serve as an incentive to acquire easy monitoring capability as soon as possible in the interest of the proper administration of justice. 15. Subject to the conditions of bail, the accused shall be allowed to enter into gainful employment with any party situated and registered within the Republic of Namibia or elsewhere, but excluding the Republic of Angola, Iceland, and the United Arab Emirates, on condition of disclosure of such employer's identity to Messrs. Marondetse and Lutibezi of the Prosecutor General's Office. And 16, the state is permitted to lawfully monitor and police the aforementioned conditions of bail. The order is ready for distribution with Ms. Iteta.
As the court pleases, my lord, we indebted to this court.
As it pleases the court, your lordship.
My lord, I'm not sure if your lordship still wants the full list your lordship had required earlier. We do have same for production. The list of the addresses.
No, I don't require it anymore.
Thank you, my lord. We indebted to your lordship.
Thank you. If I will be glad if but there's no condition pertaining to that. I have demarcated the areas where the accused will be allowed and not be allowed. And the hours he will be allowed only to stay within the Finkenstein area, and the hours he will be allowed only to stay within the borders on ambit of F229. The court is adjourned.